Let me ask you about this letter here from Representative Nunes. Putting that deadline on things, how does that change the equation right now? Will they meet it?
Well, I think the letter was great, and I applaud Chairman Nunes for doing that. I think that deadline needs to be enforceable. Trish, we've been doing this for months and months, asking very simple questions about the genesis of this investigation, about how the dossier came into the FBI's possession, whether the FBI paid for the dossier, whether they used it to get surveillance on any Trump associates. And those are all very easy questions to actually answer. And yet we've been met with resistance after resistance after resistance. So I think they have until next week to do it. And then if not, you know, I think the House is going to have to move on to different measures in order to force compliance.
Congressman, what do you think that resistance is about?
You know, it's hard to tell. I mean, there you have a lot of people in there who've been a part of the bureaucracy for a long time. I mean, to me, the questions are very easy to answer. If you said, of course we didn't use the dossier, then you would just say that. And I think the reason is probably that some of the answers to these questions are going to call further into question the behavior of some of the people involved at the very highest levels of both the Clinton and Russia investigations, people like Peter Strzok. So we need answers to those questions, and I think what they're doing by resisting, but then actually leaking certain facts to the media. There was just an article in the New York Times yesterday where they're leaking about this Papadopoulos, which actually conflicts with previous stories and is not anything that anyone's been able to say under oath on the record to us. You know, you look at that and say, okay, you're not willing to answer Congress's questions under oath, but you'll leak things to the media? That is not the way this is supposed to work.
Well, you know, you think about, frankly, who was running the FBI, and James Comey, sort of leaker-in-chief, if you would, himself. I still remember being absolutely stunned during his testimony when he admitted that he was the one who actually leaked things to his friend at Columbia, who could then in turn leak it to the New York Times. I mean, shocking to me, because it tells you, perhaps, Congressman, a little bit about the culture there. And I guess one of the things I'm amazed by is, if they're so into leaking, how come we haven't heard more about this so-called collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians? Why haven't they been able to find anything, to pinpoint anything, to leak to the media?
Oh, yeah. I mean, that if there was any evidence of collusion, that would have been leaked months and months ago. You can bet your bottom dollar on that. But it's very, very frustrating to see. A lot of times they will refuse to answer Congress's questions because they'll say, well, you know, it's classified. We're not sure that we can do it in this setting. But then they'll leak classified information to the media. So it's just very, very frustrating process. But you're exactly right. I think there has not been evidence of collusion. And one of the kind of data points that best supports that is, I think if there was evidence of that, I think the press would have gotten it by now.
All right. So let's go back to the Trump dossier for a moment, because this was put together, as everyone knows by now, by a firm, hired a sort of hit job kind of firm to dig up dirt on someone as Fusion GPS. And they were brought in and eventually down the road, employed in part by folks close to Clinton, Hillary Clinton, and bankrolled by the Democrats. I guess the big question that we have to ask is, was Russia deliberately trying to mess with us, with the United States of America, and our whole election process? And did they deliberately feed false information to Christopher Steele, the British spy that was hired to compile this dossier? I think that deserves a lot of answers. And the scary thought is that possibly the FBI used this thing to then get FISA warrants.
Well, we know for sure that Steele was getting information from Foreign Service Bureau sources in Russia. I mean, there's just no doubt about it. We're trying to figure out whether he actually paid for that information, that it's possible that he did do that. And so you're right, you have the Democrats paying. Now, they funneled the money through a Perkins Coe law firm,
correct,
who then paid Fusion to try to camouflage this. With the lids been blown off on that, we now know this was the Democrats' money. Steele is actively working with Russians. And yes, I think it's without question that he was fed a lot of disinformation. I don't even know that any of these Russian sources could have dreamed that this thing would have been used the way it has been, potentially. And so if that was their aim, I think it was successful. But they bring this dossier back, and this thing is basically just a bunch of garbage. And so if that was relied upon, That is something that's very, very important. And there's a very easy answer to that question, Trish. We just need to get it. You know,